G'day everyone, welcome to another episode of Python with Lego Mindstorms Robot Inventor Set. Today we're going to look at loops and events to control your robot. G'day everyone, my name is Gary, and if you haven't already, make sure you are following all these lessons in order, because I go through some of the basics in the previous episodes, and these lessons build on top of each other. So if anything doesn't make sense, make sure you check out the video from the last lesson. So today we're going to continue working with Tricky with the basketball hero upgrade. So one of the things that robots are really good at doing is repeating things. Anything that is really repetitive, that is really boring, things that people don't want to do, robots are really good at doing that. And that's why we have factories and assembly lines that are populated by robots, because robots never get tired, they never get bored, and they just continuously do things over and over again. So today we're going to look at how we can use loops in our code to repeat things a certain number of times. And also to as a further extension of that, we're going to learn how to use the buttons to create events as well. Okay, so if you haven't already, make sure you build Tricky from the previous episode with the with basketball hero upgrade, and then we're going to create a new project. So here is your Mindstorms software. What we want to do is we go into projects, and then we want to scroll all the way down to create a new project. Make sure you highlight Python and then click create. Once you've created it, let's save this project. We're going to save it as CA Python loops. Events, say Python loops events. I know you can see the full name over here. I'll just retype it on the screen afterwards. So here is the code that comes with all your projects. You remember you can remove these if you don't want to, but for now let's keep everything here. So we are importing all of our Mindstorms classes at the top. Then this is just a hint to create all your objects in one area. And then down the bottom, we are creating our executable code. Okay, so what are we going to try and do today? Well, let's start off with making our basketball hero robot do some exercise. Exercise is really good for us. And my personal trainer always tells me to do 8 reps, like 4 sets of 8 reps or whatever. And what does that mean? It means I have to lift some weights a certain number of times, and that's going to improve my muscle. So we're going to do that with our robot here. We're going to make it so that it's going to lift its arm and lower it 8 times. Okay, so if you followed the lesson before, we can probably just copy and paste the lifting and lowering motion of the arm 8 times, right? But what if I said to do it 20 times, 40 times, 100 times? It's just not really sensible to copy and paste line by line and make 100 lines, right? That would be a very terrible way to do it. So if you've done this in Scratch before, you'll know that there is a repeat block. And the repeat block can be translated as a loop in Python. I'll show you how to do that. So first of all, let's do all the things that we defined in our robot. So let's go movement motors equals motor pair A and B. Okay. And then we have a lifting arm, right? So lifting arm equals motor. And it's a motor C. Whoop, not a motor pair, motor C. All right. Here, so we've defined our motor pair and we've defined our lifting arm motor. Here we are going to do just one action first. We're going to lower the arm and lift the arm. Okay? So we go lifting arm dot run to position, and then we're going to go 0, shortest path, and say 20. Okay, so for run to position, shortest path and the default speed over here, they get automatically populated if you don't write it out. So you don't have to write the whole thing out if you don't want to. You can just have 0 where it will run shortest path to 0. But I like to write it out as a habit in case you need to think about it. Sometimes if you don't write it out, you don't think about it, and then you wonder, oh, why is it moving so quickly or so slowly? It's because this gives you a bit more control. And of course, just like what we said in the last lesson, you can change shortest path to be counterclockwise or clockwise. Okay, so run to position 0, and then we're going to run to position 270. And make sure you've connected your robot to your computer. Follow the last video if you don't remember how to do that. And then let's have a look at our robot running the code. Here we go. There we go. So the arm lowers and lifts itself up. That's good. So let's go back into our code. Now remember what we're trying to do. We're trying to make it so that our code repeats itself. Let's say we want to repeat this 8 times, okay? And then the bad way to do it, if you see this question in like an exam at school or in some sort of Python school, or maybe you're applying for a junior programming role, and they say, oh, do something X number of times, and then what you do is you go, oh, I'll just copy and I'll go paste, 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 or something like that. It's like, oh, yes, I'm doing it X number of times, but that's not how you do it, okay? What we need to do is do a loop, and this is how you do something called a for loop. A for loop. What does a for loop mean? A for loop is a loop where you define a fixed number for which to repeat something that certain number of times. Okay, so we go 4, and then this is a variable that we create, a temporary variable, for I in range. I'll talk about what it is in a bit. 0, 8, 1. And then close the bracket, column, and then every line in here we're going to indent it. So to indent, we press the tab key after you highlight the lines. Okay, so press the tab key. For I in range 0, 8, 1, column, and then do that. So what is this saying? It's saying that for I is a temporary variable for what we're going to put in to substitute each iteration. In range, so the range function, what it does is it counts from 0 to 8. From 0 to 8. So it's going to go from 0, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, but it doesn't include 8. So it is inclusive of the first number, but exclusive of the second number. So when you count from 0 to 8, it counts 8 times, and the 8 times are from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay? It doesn't count 8, but it counts 8 times because it counted 0. Does that make sense? And then, comma 1, what does that mean? That means that it is going to count in increments of 1. So if you wanted to, you can count in increments of 2, and then it would just halve the number of times that it would count. So, but here we're saying to count from 0 to 8 exclusive of 8. And that's going to, in total, be counting 8 times. So it's going to lift and lower the arm 8 times. That's what this means, the for loop means. Okay, so this is exactly the same as a repeat block. Let's have a look and see it in action. So if I run this code, see that? Eight. Okay, so that's how you do a repeat block in Python. Okay, so this is how you do something called a loop. And in particular, this is called a for loop. Okay, a for loop is really useful for if you know exactly how many times you want to repeat something. So that's what we're doing. We're saying to repeat this exactly 8 times, right? But what if you want to repeat something until something happens, right? If you want to repeat something until something happens, in Scratch there is a block that says repeat until, right? But in Python we don't have a wait until or repeat until equivalent. What we do have is something called a while loop. Okay, so we just learned how to do a for loop. Now let's do the same thing with a while loop. How does a while loop work? Let's have a look. All right, so we did a for loop, but let's comment that out. Remember, we commented out with three double quotation marks. A while loop. So a while loop is when you want to repeat something until something happens. So instead of using I, this time I'm using x. So let's say x equals 0. This is going to be the number of times that I'm counting, right? We're going to count x up until it reaches 8, and then we're going to stop the loop. So we're going to repeat something until x reaches 8, right? So here we can go like this. We go a while. Well, x is less than 8, colon. Then we do the same thing. We lift and lower our arm. Control C to copy, Control V to paste. Lift and lower our arm, but we also need to increase x by 1. And to increase x by 1, we can do something like this. X equals x plus 1. Okay? But a real programmer knows that instead of write the shorthand for x equals x plus 1 is x plus equals 1. Okay, so this is just a shorter way of saying to increase or increment x by 1. Okay, so it's going to say x is going to start off as 0, and then while x is less than 8, we're going to move the arm up and down and then increment x. Does that make sense? And that's going to do exactly the same thing as the for loop. It's going to repeat the up and down motion 8 times. So let's watch this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8. Right? So it looks like our robot has had its workout done. So why are there two different types of loops? Okay, Remember, the for loop is where we fix a range, where we say, this is the fixed number of times we want to do something, right? And a while loop, even though what we did with the while loop just then is exactly the same as the for loop, a while loop is more like, imagine if our robot was carrying a hammer, right? How many times is that hammer going to hit a nail before the nail is fully flushed to the table? Well, there's no telling, right? Because one time it might take 3 hits of the nail, one time it might take like 10 hits of the nail. Maybe it's like extra hard to hit the nail through. So that's when we need to use a while loop. We need to say to repeat something until something happens, right? We are using the while loop because we go, while we see the nail is still like not fully indented, we need to keep repeating this action. And that's why we would use a while loop as opposed to a for loop. But for our purposes, both loops are completely fine, just for now, right? But and that's just for the purposes of repeating something 8 times, okay? But now we want to do something with our buttons, okay? So a while loop is useful for not only repeating something until something happens, it's also what people we use in Python, what we use to create a forever loop, okay? So a forever loop is basically a while loop that never ends, right? And for that, we're going to create an event using these buttons, okay? So I'm going to show you how to use the left button to move the arm up and down. Remember I said that a while loop is useful for creating a an event? Well, this is how we do it. While true. While true is how you create a forever loop. Okay, so we go while true colon. That means that inside anything that's indented under while true, it's going to keep repeating it forever. What are we going to repeat? Well, we're going to repeat an event. While true, hub dot left button dot wait until pressed. What are we going to do after we wait for it to be pressed? Well, we're going to put all this inside it. So we indent this like that. Okay. So this is a while loop inside a while loop now. So we are going to say, while true, we'll wait for the left button to be pressed. And then once it's pressed, we repeat this, this block. Okay, so let's see how this works in action. Okay, so it's made a beep, but it's not moving because it's waiting, excuse me, because it's waiting for us to press the left button. See? So now it is going to operate only when we press the left button. Okay. So that's how we use repeat blocks in Python. So we learned how to do a for loop and how to do a while loop as well. And we learned how different types of loops are used in different kind of situations. Next time we're going to learn about conditionals. So learning about how to use logic in your code so that your robot can decide to do things on its own. I can't wait to teach you the next one. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Please like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed the lesson, and I will see you again next time. Bye-bye.